Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Rare Replay. My name is Josh Jepson, but you know the already. Today, we're going to jump into Attic Attack, which is actually, I played this a little bit on here, but I'm not super well-versed in this game. I do know the basic concept of the game, so it's going to be really interesting, kind of seeing how well I play this. But this is basically an adventure game. Which is one of my favorite kind of games. Back on the Atari, there was a game called I believe it was just Adventure, which is you just play as a cube, like a little square that you try to find the keys and adventure through that. But this reminds me an awful lot of that, only obviously a little bit more advanced. And we'll get into that in a second here. So the point of the game is to recover the pieces of the golden key and escape the haunted castle. So let's jump into it and give it a try. We'll start a brand new game here. Basically, we get a choice of three different characters. We get to play as a knight, a wizard, or a serf, and each of these characters has, the only difference between the different characters is their attacks, but also, they have, different shortcuts. So we're gonna play as the wizard today, and I believe the shortcut for this particular character is the clocks. And the whole idea is to find the pieces of the golden key, and escape through the door, the exit door, with the key. So we're gonna look around and see. And basically, all these collectibles that we get are gonna refill our health. I just want to make sure. Yeah. Okay. So like shortcuts are basically anything on the wall, like the knight in shining armor, and the oh, crap. Can we get out of here, please? No, bat, you're not helpful. Oh, okay. Alright, Ghost, you're also not helpful. Oh, I don't have a green key. So all the different doors are locked. This is the kind of game that I would make. You know what I mean? This is the kind of game that I would definitely, like... There we go, there's the green key. A bowl of rice or something. When I first played this game, I thought you had to, find the secret hidden switches. Like, I thought when you touched certain things in the level, it unlocked these doors, but these doors really are just timed. They just unlock themselves. Okay, alright. There's the red key. I'll take that. That doesn't really help me here in this room, however, with the mummy man, who doesn't die in one hit, apparently. Green door, however, helps. Yeah, so this is pretty much it. This is the game. And you have a certain limited time to do it, which is why it's so interesting. It's an adventure game, but you have a time limit. I don't have the blue key yet. I've run into an awful lot of blue doors. This is gonna take me back around. I really wish I had some sort of map, actually. Oh crap. Okay, money bags. I'll take that. Wait, can I pick that up? Oh, I don't know what that does. I actually don't know what any of the items do. But you can pick up different items, and I guess they do stuff. But that doesn't really help me here. Okay. Bye, squid. Hello. Nope, you're not helping. Get out of here. Okay, so, oh man. So I saw a video of this because I wasn't sure how to play the game, and the game doesn't really tell you because it's an old game. And one of the things that I discovered from watching the video is that the keys can be, I think the keys are in set positions, but you're gonna need to have, here, I'll go down there again. This is a floor that I was already on. I'm about to die. I'm hoping, yeah, there's some food. I don't have the yellow key, but I'm sure it'll be down here somewhere. We can go down further, or we can keep looking for the key. Oh my god, red key will help. Green. I don't even know. I'm losing track of where I am, pretty much. Here, let's go this way. Blue is not going to help. Oh, it's a freaking ghost thing. I don't even know. I don't even know what these things are. The whole, pretty much the entire point is going to be to... just walk around aimlessly. Okay, so actually the shortcut, I lied. The shortcut is the bookshelf for the wizard. I think the serf gets the, whatever it's called. I don't even know what that is. Oh, Christ. Witch? Witchy-poo? Witchy-witchy-witchy-poo? Sorry, what does it say? Oh, the serf gets the knight in shining armor, and I think the knight gets the... Actually, the knight might get the shining knight in shining armor. That actually makes more sense. All right, let's go this direction. I'll go in here first. I think I should probably go down there ultimately. Pumpkin face, my least favorite. Open the door. Open, says me. Okay, so I decided I'm going to switch over to the snapshots for Attic Attack because the main game is actually, I'm really having that much fun with it, to be honest with you. It's actually been quite difficult to find the bits of the key. So I'm actually going to go through here. I don't think I've completed any of these. No, I completed one of them. This one here. You're invulnerable but lost. Find a way out of the caverns as quickly as possible. So basically, you just have to find a way to the stairs as quickly as possible. So I will just do this one since this is the one that I've done already before, and I'm playing as the surf, which I don't know what a surf is, but I'll take it anyway. Can I go to the exit here? I'll go this way then. Fine. Jesus Christmas. Pretty sure I played this level, although I think it's slightly different. Hey, there's a blue key. I'll take that. Let's go this way. Yeah, it is slightly different. It's definitely slightly different because I didn't have the blue key before, even though I really wanted it. Oh, Christ. Yeah, so I played for like 10 minutes earlier, and I think I'm probably going to cut out most of that because it was just... The game is... There's nothing to the game unless you find things. I think this is my least favorite one so far. I don't have the green key yet. Oh, I can fight Dracula here. Sup, dude? Sup, Dracula, bro? Okay. This way. And really, this goes on forever, too, which is an interesting thing, because usually the snapshots are like, oh, it's like a timed challenge to get out of this place. In this case, it's not really because the entire point is to escape in as quickly as possible. So you just keep going until you find the exit, which is really kind of in the spirit of the actual game, because the entire game basically keeps going forever. Well, that's not entirely true. It doesn't keep going forever because eventually you run out of lives because your health runs down automatically. But, oh, hey, I think I can go through here, can't I? No. Okay, so I was right. This is it. This is the exit. What am I doing? I like how I found the exit, decided to go back and check for a shortcut. Oh well, whatever. Oh, I didn't mean to retry this. Let's exit, and we'll try a different snapshot. I've tried a couple of these, and I've been really, really bad at this. Keep your hunger bar above the halfway mark for 60 seconds. Mmm, chicken. Oh god. Oh god. This is the first one I played, and I think I played this before I even played the main game, the actual game, so I didn't really understand how to play the game, or that I could get, health basically by collecting things, and so I was just kind of like standing around killing enemies until I like lived, and so the whole point is to keep my health bar up for 60 seconds or be above a certain point for 60 seconds, which means I need to go around and collect as much health as possible. I'm in the attic now. Yeah, bitch, I got whatever the milk is. I think, I don't know. It's milk. My favorite. It's delicious. Calcium. Part of this natural breakfast. I don't think... Oh, God. I did not mean to fall down here, but that's okay, because there's probably more food down here. Possibly chicken. Chicken. And cross. I don't know what the cross is for, but I will figure it out. One day, perhaps. I don't know what that was. A can of beans, perhaps? Oh, we're back at the beginning. Oh, that's right. We went upstairs, didn't we? Okay, so I think I beat it, which is kind of unique. I'm gonna lose. I wanna see how long I can go for. Go downstairs again. I like how when you go through the thing, it keeps the time going, but not your health doesn't keep dropping while you're dropping. So this is actually really good for me to keep dropping. There we go. And there's more food down here too. I'm actually doing a really, really good job right now. Amazing! Hello, Frankenstein's monster. How are you doing in this cavern today? Hanging out with Dracula the Batman, yo. Dracula is basically Batman. He turns into a bat. I got a wrench! Yeah! That's gonna heal me. Not really, though. But I did it, though! 1 minute, 48 seconds. Not freaking bad, yo. Not freaking bad. I'm excited about that. I got another stamp. One more, and I unlock another behind-the-scenes thing, which is cool. All your basement are belong to us! Visit every room in the basement as quickly as possible. And it looks like it starts us in a room with four keys, so this should be pretty easy. I'll get three of them, and then I'll just go. Okay, so every room. I don't have yellow or red yet. So I'll do every room except for red. And then I will do my darndest to go in red whenever I can. Green, I'll take that. Health as well. Need to remember to get health wherever possible. Blue is good. Alright, hang on. Nope. You're drastically in the way, sir. Here, that's fine. I will tank the hit. Oh, hey, I found a part of the key! I don't need the key, though. I found a part of the key in the actual, like, in the snapshot. That's amazing. Okay, so that's 9 rooms. I don't have any of the red rooms. I don't have any of those. But that's okay, because some of these rooms connect to multiple rooms. Go through here. Or rather, so you can probably go through every room in the basement without having to have all of the keys. Which is good. We'll go in this room. This room. I'm actually doing a really, really freaking good job here. Here, let's go this way, because I'm sure that up would lead me to a thing that I've already been to. Maybe. I actually don't know. No, I've already been here. Oh, can I keep going down? Oh, okay, never mind. All right. I was just wondering if there were multiple layers of the basement, but that's not how that works. The lowest one is the caverns. So I screwed it up with two rooms remaining, unfortunately. But that does give you guys a pretty good idea of what to expect from Attic Attack. Unfortunately, the main game itself is less fun than the actual snapshots, so at least in my opinion. I think I would have had more fun if I had come across one of the key parts, at least one of them, so I had a little bit more hope. But I felt like I went through pretty much every room in the basement and didn't, or the caverns, and pretty much didn't find any of the key parts. But I think they could be in any room in the dungeon anyway, so hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode of Rare Replay. Once again, my name is Josh Jepson. Thank you guys for watching. Please check out some of the other stuff that I've been working on. Like this video and subscribe for more Replay. And please check out the Patreon page and consider supporting me over there. Once again, my name is Josh, and I will see you in the next one.